particularly pressing news in all ramifications. This is an election that INEC and all of them have about 3 years at least to prepare for. And up until a few days ago, we had assurances that everything is set to go. So I'm really shocked, and I will not know what excuse they will give. The INEC chairman spoke in terms of logistics. I don't see how to understand it. But I'm told that they are having a meeting this afternoon in Abuja, and I hope that they will come with better clarifications. But clearly, this is not good for the politics. Look at the international observers, some of them have been here for the last 2 weeks. What do you expect them to do now? It's really not a good day for politics in Nigeria and in Africa.
So did you foresee, are you seeing any foul play on the part of the ruling party?
Definitely, yeah, people do say that I still spoke with a fire. Yes, INEC is supposed to be independent, but they have appointing officers and people who confirm the appointment. Definitely, this appears to be the voice of Jacob and the hand of his own.
Well, going forward, sir, do you foresee the commission conducting a free and fair election that Nigeria will be proud of?
Well, Nigeria will not give room for any foul play, and I think we should place them on notice that this is not about election between two individuals, it's about INEC versus Nigeria. People have said clearly that the ongoing regime is not the best we can have. And INEC have a duty to be loyal to Nigerians, not to anybody.
Sir, people are saying calling for sanctions for what has happened, including those some people saying that the INEC chairman should resign. What do you think?
It may not be easy for you to ask the chairman to resign if you don't want to create bigger problems. If you want to now have the election next week and you ask the chairman to resign, you are looking for bigger problems. I think you probably should allow him to do what he has to do before you talk about sanctions.